The sign says Equator Latitude Zero. It's a magnet for tourists from all over the world.
Just put 1 foot in winter and 1 foot in summer.
Welcome to the Middle of the Earth Museum in Quito, Ecuador. It features a 30-meter tall monument, almost 100 feet, with a globe on top. There's also a village with shops, restaurants, and exhibit halls. But the main attraction is a yellow line that runs through the facility. It marks the equatorial line that divides the Earth between the northern and southern hemispheres. Or does it?
You know already that it's not the actual
Yes,
line.
I do know that.
Does that. Is that a spoiler for you?
No. It's got to pick a place, right? It's practical.
Museum authorities do not dispute the fact that this is not the actual equatorial line. A French expedition drew the line in the 18th century.
It's a symbolic place that we have. That was settled here according with the medicines that we had 200 years ago in 1736.
The error was discovered only a few years ago thanks to global positioning technology. In fact, we can talk about three different equatorial lines. The symbolic one here at the Middle of the Earth Museum is this yellow line where most tourists take their pictures. The second one is where those two mountains intersect and a V-shape is formed. That's where the ancient people of this area believed was the center of the world. The third one is located about 200 meters in that location. That's where most modern GPS systems indicate latitude zero is located. For this American tourist, the current line is just fine.
If you stand on a state line in the United States, 1 foot in California, 1 foot in Arizona, you know, I mean, it doesn't really matter, but it's just a symbol of being in two places at once.
And so the tourists keep coming, about 400,000 a year, to have their pictures taken at a symbol that remains more powerful than the truth. Rafael Romo, CNN.
Should we then just keep it a secret among us?
Just among you and I, yes. I think that's a good idea.
Not exactly at the equator.